वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, वी आर स्टडिंग द सब्जेक्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस इन विच वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक अदर एक्सट्रूजन प्रोसेसेस। इम्पैक्ट एक्सट्रूजन, इट इज परफॉर्म्ड एट हायर स्पीड एंड शॉर्टर स्ट्रोक्स। द बिलेट इज एक्सट्रूडेड थ्रू द डाई बाय इम्पैक्ट प्रेशर एंड नॉट जस्ट बाय अप्लाइंग प्रेशर, बट इम्पैक्टिंग कैन बी कैरिड आउट as forward extrusion, backward extrusion or combination of these, which is shown in the figure below. The starting blank is given in the figure. Forward extrusion is the name of the figure. V is the velocity and velocity of the punch. There are two dies, left and right. In between there is a workpiece. Then in next figure we will see the punch is applied on the workpiece and extruded part is produced. The next is backward extrusion. In backward extrusion starting blank is given, die are given, the punch is stroke on the die and workpiece with velocity V and force F. In the next figure, extruded part is given and which is produced. Then in next figure we will see combined extrusion, that is forward extrusion and backward extrusion. Starting blank, dies are given, punch is forced with velocity V on the die and workpiece. The extruded part is produced in this process. Impact extrusion is carried out as cold work forming. Very thin walls are possible by backward impact extrusion method. Example, making the toothpaste tubes, battery cases. Advantages of IE: large reduction and high production rates. Hydrostatic extrusion, the figure shows the hydrostatic extrusion in which ram is forced by force F and velocity V. Container is given in between, there is a work billet and fluid is present in the container. The extruded shape is produced, that is work production of the hydrostatic extrusion. In hydrostatic extrusion, the billet is surrounded by fluid inside the container and the fluid is pressurized by the forward motion of the ram. There is no friction inside the container because of the fluid. The friction is minimized at the die opening. If used at high temperatures, special fluids or procedures must be followed. Hydrostatic pressure on the work and no friction situation increases the material's ductility. Hence, this process can be used on metals and that would be too brittle for conventional extrusion methods. This process is possible, also applicable for ductile metals, and here high reduction ratios are possible. The preparation of starting work billet is important. The billet must be formed with a taper and at one end and taper at one end to fit tightly into the die entry angle so that it acts as a seal to prevent fluid leakage through die hole under pressure. Defects during extrusion. We will now see the defects during extrusion. Center burst. This is an internal crack that develops at the result of tensile stresses along the center axis of the workpiece during extrusion. A large material motion at the outer regions pulls the material along the center of the work beyond a critical limit. Bursting occurs. Conditions that promote this defect are higher die angles, low extrusions ratios, and impurities in the work metal. This is also called as chevron cracking. Piping. It is the formation of a sink yellow in the end of the billet. This is minimized by the usage of a dummy block whose diameter is slightly less than that of billet. We will see in the figure center burst piping. These are the examples of center burst and piping. Surface cracking. This defect results from high workpiece temperatures that causes cracks to develop at the surface. They also occur at higher extrusion speeds, leading to high strain rates and heat generation. Higher friction at the surface and surface chilling of high temperature billets in hot extrusion also causes this defect. The third figure is surface cracking. Wire rod bar drawing. In this bulk forming process, a wire rod bar are pulled through a dial hole, reducing their cross-sectional area. Wire rod or bar drawing. In this, starting block is stock. Starting stock D0 is the diameter of the starting stock. Alpha is the angle of stock with the die. There are two die, upper die and lower die. Final workpiece of required size is produced. DF is the diameter of the final workpiece, rod, wire or bar. Difference between the drawing and rod drawing. Difference between the wire drawing and rod drawing. Initial stock size. The basic difference between bar drawing and wire drawing is the stock size that is used for forming. Bar drawing is meant for large diameter bar and rod, while wire drawing is meant for small diameter stock. Wire sizes of the order of 0.03 mm are produced in wire drawing. Obtaining operating stages. Stages. Bar drawing is generally done as a single stage operation in which stock is pulled through one die opening. The inlet bars are straight and not in the form of coil, which limits the length of the work that can be drawn. This necessitates a batch type operation. In contrast, wire is drawn from coils consisting of several hundred meters of wire and is drawn through a series of dies. The number of dies varies between 4 to 12. This is termed as continuous drawing because of the long production runs that are achieved with the wire coils. The segments can be butt welded to the next to make the operation truly continuous. Thank you, friends, for watching this lecture.